virtues or ourselves can walk the path of Jesus within God's light. As I proceed, do not label me as a judge, for I am merely a leader, a leading messenger of God, as our brother Jesus and his disciples were. Now as I begin, I need you all to unstrap your seatbelts, cut the chain, and be prepared to spiritually leave your seats and soar with me among the realm of truth. As a messenger of God, I believe we all create our own universes as demigods. No one can tell you who God is but you. Each and every soul is unique. Each has different spiritual needs and must experience what is needed for soul growth. Our lives consist of learning lessons from our experiences, both the positive and the negative. The last time I stood before you all, I taught the lesson of life is what you make it, and no one can tell you who God is but you. So I want you all to take this in perspective as I stand before you today. For I'm going to challenge so many of your beliefs with my own, but that's the purpose as Jesus' disciples who didn't go out to convert people, but implemented some kind of belief and faith in the Lord from their own perspective and knowledge of God. God gave us Jesus along with an MLK, Gandhi, Buddha, Tupac, Jesus, Badu, Ari, Sochak, etc. We are supposed to lead and teach and walk within the path of Jesus given to us by God. Do not idolize thy brother, but lead with these examples of peace and love. A lot of you have noticed I don't take communion anymore. This is because it's not a spiritual thing for me. It's become a ritual vitalization in my eyes, along with much religion, as many fights and divide themselves among one another. But one in the vine, we are all one. And last time I checked, God frowns upon idolizing anyone that is indeed and knows that judge. I now see Jesus as my leading example, my past self, or even my brother, for he led the path for a righteous cause and not a group or parish. Jesus walked and spoke for spirituality with God, which came in all forms, for no one has the same attainment of perception, but belief is greater. There's so much controversy about Kanye, but will we be having a conversation of slavery being anything more than a disgrace period, merely with us as a people be here today, if it wasn't for most of his words? Currently, Jesus is building his own nation within the mountains of California, and that's what life's about. Revolution unto evolution. Imagination. Imagination. First, it was the Illuminati, now it's the second place. People look to those at the top as if they are not beings of the same world, but it is so. We're just the gods of this universe, being true free believers and followers of the light. They simply gave the world the power of free thought, but to believe is another sight, as we should believe in all things, even those we can't see, for we can't see God, but we walk in the faith Jesus presented for us. Among the misperception the media puts on Ye, we've also grown to despise the misperception of 666, whereas it means the man that counts the number of the beast being the world and the number of problems of it. This leads to 1,000 years of peace, where the Bible says God will fall to earth with heaven as the devil will reign other parts, and which I perceive as the next evolutionary period for peace and evolutionary growth, which doesn't last forever, being that we need war for the world to continue to progress through the various revolutions, being the mere correlation of yin yang, good, bad, heaven, hell. In my opinion, I believe numbers are a way of meaning to speaking to the divine, as 3 is well connected to Jesus, 4 meaning prosperity, and 5 leading to change. I've encountered all numbers before, sometimes more than 3 times on the same days, on multiple clocks and just signs all of my life. But in the past 2 years of praying every day, I've seen numbers all day, every day, and I use them to speak with God. Even as I was writing this mere piece on numbers, I encountered 2 threes, being 106 and 109. And within this, I crossed my heart 3 times, and so I do all day to speak with God, Jesus, and my angels of the divine. While editing this on 6-3, being the day of Jesus, my unread messages had been 5, 6, 7 for a minute now, as they still are. And my name is that sequence, as Malik holds 5 letters, my middle name 6, and my last 7. I believe we weren't sent here to dwell on the hatred of others as Trump or quote-unquote white supremacy. We were put here to shine our light in the darkness. Our people always speak of buying property in our neighborhoods for it to change things, and even though that's okay, what about the unused land in our own country? We have islands that are untouched with treasure, and our people barely make up 16% of the U.S. population, and we dwell on the police brutality and political changes when the sky anymore, nor a pit of fire in the depths of the abyss. I believe we create our own heaven on earth with the energy we let out, and upon our transition from this being, we can be guided many places, but the greatest being returned into the light of God and becoming an all-seeing light. But upon our energies here in this physical being, we can be building entire nations within Africa if we can get past another race in the end where we're taking innocent lives. If we're truly followers of God, how can we dwell on those things if life is truly God's plan? An old friend told me I'm destroying core principles of life, but I believe I'm leading the retrograde for a new order of belief within the world. For before America or even Greece, there was Timbuktu, and there lie truths of the sun where many traveled to learn and be awakened. Our people danced to the sun and built pyramids and tombs. We weren't buried 6 feet under. We were either burned during sunset or sunfall, or wrapped and put into godly coffins for eternity. If anyone's destroying core principles, it's the colonizers taking our people from their resting places and putting them in museums as if they're for amusement of their children. These same colonizers learned from our people and brought death upon us, destroying our core values and beliefs for their own egos. Every once in a while, I have dreams of me flying, and I'm as light as a feather, jumping from place to place. I don't believe they are a coincidence. I believe sleep was non-existent in God's dead flying. It began with the nourishments they put into their bodies, fruits, veggies, and lentils. And do you know who these gods were? In the colonizer's term, Jesus, the first son of the light, or at least the first day, crucified. As Bado said, most intellects don't believe in God, but they fear us just the same. Please do not envy or hate the colonizers, for life is truly God's plan, and within the past millennium, God wanted us here today. I believe that our people lost their ways when the colonizers kept coming over from the cold of death. We began to judge as they envied. We were so full of ourselves, we poured a yay and bluntly told them we are the gods of the universe, without humbleness terms. I believe we also made the same mistake so today by doubting our own brothers, being Jesus. For as I quote UEP, when one black man stands to lead reform, there's always another to call him crazy. Before they crucified Jesus, there was a choice, Jesus or the thief, God or death, yay or the colonizers, freedom or slavery. To follow God is a choice within. The fruit did not seek Eve. Eve sought the fruit, but why? The snake, quote-unquote devil, the darkness, she gave into her own physical being because she was quote-unquote hungry. But who knows what God would have gifted her and Adam with? And honestly, who cares? Because without that act, we wouldn't be here today. God told them not to, as you test the child with the red button. It's about the free will of thought. Have the choice of believing and trusting God, and that's what makes thee so beautiful, because in the midst of nothingness, God ignited thyself from nothing. Hence, quote unquote, the Big Bang Theory. So as I end this, please ignite the light within yourselves and rise from your tombs. Transcend this physical being and become free believers. And let's build new nations among the world. Stop telling yourself you're happy. Listen to God and jump off the cliff with me, with faith and trust in Almighty God.